हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू बिगिन द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर, दैट इज आर फर्स्ट स्कूल. ओके, एज यू नो दैट दिस इज चैप्टर फर्स्ट. इन दैट लेट्स सी व्हाट न्यू वी हैव टू स्टडी. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी कम टू नो दैट व्हाट इज फैमिली, देन टाइप्स ऑफ फैमिली, एंड विल ऑल्सो कम टू नो अबाउट द फैमिली रिलेशन, सम फैमिली रिलेशंस, एंड देन आफ्टर why family is called as our first school. Okay, now, so what is family? Students, everyone, all of you have your own family. In that you have your mother, father, your brother, sisters, some of you have your grandparents also. And as you know that these all people live in a house, and they are just related to each other with a blood relation. So, if we are going to define family, we can say that a group of consisting of parents and their children living together as a unit is called family. Means, if there is a group of your parents, suppose that your mother, your father, you, your brother, your sister, so your mother and father, these two are your parents, and their children are your people, means you, your brother, your sister. So, if you all living together, then it is called as family. Clear? Now, it is depending upon you that how many family members you have in your family and who are living in your family. The second thing is that family members have blood relations. Blood relations means they are directly related to each other by blood. Like you are related to your father. Your father means the person who gave the birth is your known as your mother, and your brother, your sister, these peoples you have with the blood relation. If you're talking about your grandparents, your grandparents is also having the blood relation with you and your father, because they gave birth to your father, and so on. In this way we can say that they all have the blood relations. And next one is family members shares the home, means they share their home, they live in a home, and it may be possible that they live in different rooms, but the home will be, they will share the home. Means overall, if we are talking about the family, we can say that it is just a group of some people or group of the parents who live with their children. Clear? Now, the next one is types of family. How many types of family are there? Basically, there are the three types of family. That is a small family, large family, and joint family. Now, one by one, we will discuss that what is a small family, what is large family, and what is joint family. Come, what is small family? A small family with one or two children is known as a small family. Means if a parent, suppose your mother and father plus their one or two children. Okay, if in a family there are parents like mother, father, and one or two children, only one or two children will be there, it can be considered as a small family. Means overall, if we are calculating the total number of the family members, it will be 4, 3, 4, 5, not more than that. Okay, now the next one is large family. A family with more than two children is called large family. Now, if suppose that in your family members you are living with your mother, father, along with that you have two brothers, two sisters, and your grandparents also, means your grandmother, grandfather. In this way, the family will be large. The family members will be more in compared to the small family. So, the family in which these all members will be there, whatever we have discussed, they are called as the large family. Now, the next one is joint family. A family in which parents and their children, grandparents, uncle, aunts, cousins live together under the roof is called as joint family. Means, if suppose if only a mother, father and one or two children, there will be small family. If mother, father, two or more, three, four children or their grandparents also, they are living together, it is known as large family. But if along with your grandparents, your mother, father, your brother, sister, there are your uncle and aunts and their children also, means your cousins are also, they all are living together under a single roof, it is said to be a joint family. Means joint family, in joint family, uncle and aunt will be there, your cousin will be there, your grandparents will be there. You, your brother, your sister, your mother, your father, in overall, it is the family members will be more in number in compared to the large family. Clear? Now, let's understand the family relations. As you all know that the who is our father and who is our mother, who is our brother and who is our sister. Okay? Now, there are some more family relations which we have to understand. For that, the first one is grandparents. Who are our grandparents? Who is your grandparents? If we are asking to you that who is your grandparents, you can say that my father's parents and my mother's parents will be called as my grandparents. Okay? Means your grandfather, your grandmother, your nana, your nani, these all called as the grandparents because they are the parents of your father or your mother. Now, the next one is who is called your uncles? My father's brother or my mother's brother will be called as uncles. Means if we are talking about the uncles, we can say that my father's brother or my mother's brother. Mother's brother we also used to say mama. Okay? So, and my father's brother, uncle or chacha we used to say, or bade papa, whatever you can say that. So, means uncle, if overall we are talking about uncle, it is the brother of, he is the brother of my father or my mother. Clear? Now, the next one is, who is your aunt? My father's sister, my mother's sister or my uncle's wives will be called as my aunts. Okay, we can say that that is the criteria that father's brother, father's sister, buva you used to say that. In English it is said to, it is also said as aunt. My mother's sister, that is masi, you can say that. It is also known as aunt. She is also known as aunt. And my uncle's wife is also called as my aunt. Okay, now, who will be called as your cousins? Who will be called as your cousins? My uncle and aunt's children will be called as my cousins. If your uncle and aunts have children, they are called as your cousins. Clear? Now, the next one is, why do we call family as our first school? What is the reason behind that? We call the family our first school. The reason is that the children learn to love one another, respect their elders and share the things from the families. That's why the family is called as our first school, because these things means love to one another, respect to their elders, share their things. These things we learn from our childhood when we don't go to school. When we are as small as we are not able to go to school, from that time also we learn the thing. We start to learn the things from our family members. And are from a family. That's why family is called as our first school. Student, hope you understood all these things. So from tomorrow in the next lecture, we will just solve the book exercises, whatever is given in this book. This is about the family, family members and types of the family. Hope you understand all the things. So it is my suggestion to you, just solve the book exercises, whatever is given to you. If there will be any difficulty, in the next lecture, we will discuss this. Till then, have a good day. Thank you.